It's just such a good sound. It's such a good sound. Well, hello there, and welcome back to another episode of Cocktails with Ciara. My name is Ciara, and I'm a whiskey-loving Irish gal who's on a cocktail voyage of discovery. If you are new here, I have zero professional bar experience other than a passion for making mixed drinks at home and showing you how I do it. So hit that subscribe button, stick around, and we both just might learn something, because if I can do it, you can do it. So in today's video, we are going to be doing something a little bit different, and we are going to be celebrating World Gin Day, which personally is a very important date on my calendar, and it should be on yours as well. So not only is this the perfect opportunity to delve a little bit deeper into the rather sordid history of gin, but also I'm going to be using this as a chance to revisit some of my absolute favorite classic gin cocktails. And not only that, but we are also going to be trying out some award-winning gins as well that are available exclusively at Aldi. So before we get into the rather interesting history of gin, I would just like to say a huge thank you to Aldi for working with me on today's video. Aldi has a multi-award winning range of gins for you to choose from. I have used some of their delicious gins here on my channel in the past, so it is such a pleasure to work with them on today's video. I think you're really gonna like the ones that I have to show you today. And so without rambling on too much, let's get into the history of gin. So like most of us probably know already, gin is a distilled spirit that derives its flavor from the humble juniper berry. And like a lot of older spirits that we've looked at here on this channel before, gin originated as a medicinal liquor. It was created by monks and alchemists across Europe in the early 17th century. Fun fact, the term Dutch courage actually derives from gin. It was to do with British soldiers fighting on Dutch land that would be bolstered using gin as a little bit of Dutch courage. But arguably the most interesting thing about gin's history has to be what is referred to as the gin craze, which happened between the late 17th and the early 18th century in England. And the gin craze refers to a rather sordid and revelrous time where gin consumption was completely out of control in England. And this happened because gin distillation became very, very cheap and easy to do. So at this time, gin had become so widely available that most households were producing their own gin. And as you can imagine, consumption got quite out of control, so Parliament had to pass no less than 5 different legislations to try to rein in gin consumption. There's actually a very interesting historical print entitled Gin Lane. It was created by the artist William Hogarth, and it depicts all of the kind of debauchery and revelry associated with the gin craze of the time. But thankfully, the gin craze is now just another piece of gin's interesting history, and nowadays the gins that we are drinking are far more sophisticated. So now that I've given you a little bit of history on the spirit, it's time to look at the cocktails that we're going to be making today, and also the gin that we're going to be using. So Boyle's is an award-winning gin available exclusively at Aldi, and it recently won the double gold at the prestigious San Francisco World Spirits Competition, sealing its reputation as one of the best gins in the world. It is a London dry gin in style, although it is very much Irish. So I feel as if I've definitely done enough talking. Let's go ahead and make our first cocktail of the day. We are going to be making a Boyle's raspberry martini. A good martini is one of my favorite gin cocktails, but I have never had a raspberry martini, so I'm really excited to do this little twist on a classic. We're gonna start with about 50 mils of our Boyle's raspberry blush gin. I love that sound so much. 50 mils into our mixing glass filled with ice. So in we go. Then we're gonna go in with about a teaspoon or a bar spoon of apple cider vinegar, which I have to say, I've never included in a cocktail before. Just a teaspoon or a bar spoonful. Then we are gonna go in with about 10 mils of sugar syrup. In we go. So we're also gonna go in with about 15 mils of freshly squeezed lemon juice. It should be roughly half a lemon. And then we're gonna be using another ingredient that I have never used in a cocktail before, and it is kombucha. This is some gorgeous organic wild berry kombucha. 25 mils of this. Again, we have a gorgeous pinky color. So as always, when making a martini, you want to chill your glass beforehand. So we're gonna give this a stir, and then we can strain it in. For about 15 seconds or a little bit longer, you just wanna make sure it's nicely chilled. So we're gonna go ahead and strain this into our martini glass. Oh, it looks beautiful already. And then we're gonna quickly do our garnish, which is going to be some fresh raspberries. I think I'm gonna do three, because why the hell not? Go big or go home. All right, so that looks absolutely stunning. This is our raspberry martini using the Boyle's Raspberry Blush Gin. It looks absolutely gorgeous. Let's try this one, cheers. It is fabulous. It is refreshing. It's sweet, but not too sweet. Interestingly, the kombucha and the apple cider vinegar give it like this really subtle kick, but they're not overpowering at all. All right, so we are off to a flying start. I'm gonna set this to the side and then we are gonna start onto our next cocktail. So the second cocktail that we're gonna be making today is the classic gin fizz. So to make our twist on the classic gin fizz, we are going to be starting with some Boyle's gin. We have the Boyle's Small Batch Irish Botanical Gin. Again, this is in the London Dry style. So again, we're doing 50 mils of our gin right into our shaker. And then on top of that, we're gonna do about 20 mils of fresh lemon juice. 20 mils of fresh lemon in on top. As with any gin fizz, we are gonna go in with an egg white. So the fresher the eggs, the better. But if you don't wanna use eggs, you can use aquafaba or chickpea juice will work just as well. Take it handy. And you should be fine. You can kind of use the egg itself, the shell, to separate. Beautiful. In goes our egg white. And then, because we are doing a riff on the classic gin fizz recipe, we're going to add some maple syrup. So this is the specially selected 100% pure Canadian maple syrup from Aldi. And we're gonna go in with about 15 mils. This is going to work in place of your simple syrup. It's gonna give a gorgeous bit of sweetness. Now, as always, when we're working with eggs and cocktails, we wanna do a dry shake first, which is a shake with no ice, just for about 6 seconds to let everything emulsify and to just kind of break down the egg. So just 6 seconds of a quick shake. But now we're gonna add in some ice. And we're gonna go hell for leather with shaking. For about 15 to 30 seconds, we're gonna give it a nice frothy head. Ooh, that looks good. So let's go ahead and strain it into our tumbler. Oh, gorgeous. As you can see, we've got a nice frothy head on that. That's exactly what we want. Then we are going to quickly top up with some lemonade. You can also use some Indian tonic water just to give it that nice little fizz. So I actually have some gorgeous Ridge Valley tonic water here. Top it up. Bring that little foam right up to the top. So our Boyle's gin fizz is complete and oh my goodness, look at the size of that frothy head. I am very impressed. This looks absolutely delicious. I have never used maple syrup in a gin fizz before, but look, that's what World Gin Day is all about. Trying new gins, trying riffs on classic recipes. So look, I'm dying to try this. Cheers. That is delectable. It's got that gorgeous creaminess that a classic fizz cocktail has. The maple syrup adds a certain type of sweetness that's more kind of well-rounded. It reminds me of Demerara sugar. It actually works really, really well. So I'm delighted I tried it with this. Oh, this is great. So there you have it. We have two updated takes on some classic gin cocktails using the gorgeous Boyle's gin, which is available exclusively at Aldi. So in honor of World Gin Day, what I would love to know is, what is your favorite gin cocktail? Or what is your favorite variation of a gin cocktail? Because as you can see, we fully support doing a riff on the recipe. Let me know in the comments below because I would love to know what your favorite gin cocktails are. And once again, a huge thank you to Aldi for working with me on this video. It is such a pleasure to work with a stunning Irish gin brand like this, and needless to say, I will be making many more cocktails with Boyle's in the future, and I strongly suggest you try them out for yourself. If you liked this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up, and if you'd like to see more easy cocktails that you can make at home, I will link a playlist up here. And if you have not already, then be sure to subscribe to my channel. I post new videos every single week, and I would love to have you back for more. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on my next one. Bye!